尊敬的法耶总统，尊敬的非洲联盟轮值主席阿兹瓦尼总统，尊敬的各位国家元首、政府首脑、代表团长，尊敬的联合国秘书长古特雷斯先生，
Guterres, Secretary General of the United Nations,
尊敬的非洲联盟委员会主席
Mr. Moussa Faki Mohamed, Chairperson of the AU Commission,
各位朋友
Friends,
各位嘉宾
and distinguished guests,
春华秋实
blossoms in spring,
岁物
turn into fruits in the autumn, and a bumper harvest is the reward of hard work.
很高兴
in this season of harvest, I'm delighted to gather together with so many old and new friends in Beijing to discuss grand plans for China-Africa friendship and cooperation in the new era. On behalf of the Chinese government and people, I extend a warm welcome to you all. The friendship between China and Africa transcends time and space.Surmounts mountains and oceans and passes down through generations. The founding of the Forum on China-Africa Cooperation in 2000 was a milestone in the history of China-Africa relations. Over the past 24 years, especially in the new era, China has advanced forward hand in handwith our African brothers and sisters in the spirit of sincerity, real results, amity, and good faith. We stand shoulder to shoulder with each other to firmly defend our legitimate rights and interests as once in a century changes sweep across the world. We get stronger and more resilient together by riding the tide of economic globalization, delivering tangible benefits to billions of ordinary Chinese and Africans. We share will and woe in fighting natural disasters and epidemic together, creating touching stories of China-Africa friendship. We always emphasize with and support each other, setting a stellar example of a new type of international relations. Thanks to nearly 70 years of tireless efforts from both sides, the China-Africa relations is now at its best in history. With its future growth in mind, I propose that bilateral relations between China and all African countries having diplomatic ties with China be elevated to the level of strategic relations. And that the overall characterization of China-Africa relations be elevated to an all-weather China-Africa community with a shared future for the new era. Friends and distinguished guests, modernization is an inalienable right of all countries, but the Western approach to it has inflicted immense sufferings on developing countries. Since the end of World War II, third world nations represented by China and Africa countries have achieved independence and development one after another, and have been endeavoring to redress the historical injustice of the modernization process. As we are about to celebrate the 75th anniversary of the People's Republic of China, we are going all out to build a great modern socialist country in all respects and pursue national rejuvenation through a Chinese path to modernization. And the continent is marching in solid strides toward the modernization goals set forth in the AU's Agenda 2063. China and Africa's joint pursuit of modernization will set off a wave of modernization in the global south and open a new chapter in our drive for a community with a shared future for mankind. We should jointly advance modernization that is just and equitable. In promoting modernization, we should not only follow the general rules, but also act in light of our national realities. China is ready to increase exchanges of governance experience with Africa, support all countries in exploring modernization paths befitting their national conditions, and help ensure equal rights and equal opportunities for all countries. We should jointly advance modernization that is open and win-win. Mutually beneficial cooperation is the sunny road to the betterment of long-term and fundamental interests of all countries. China is ready to deepen cooperation with Africa in industry, agriculture, infrastructure, trade and investment, promote exemplary high-quality Belt and Road cooperation projects, and build together a model for the delivery of the Global Development Initiative. We should jointly advance modernization that puts the people first. The ultimate goal of modernization is the free and full development of human beings. China will work vigorously with Africa to promote personal training, poverty reduction, and employment, enhance the sense of gain, happiness, and security of the people in the course of modernization, and ensure that all will benefit from the process. We should jointly advance modernization featuring diversity and inclusiveness, well-balanced material and spiritual advancement, a lofty objective of modernization. China will enhance people-to-people and cultural exchanges with Africa, champion mutual respect, inclusiveness, and coexistence of different civilizations on our way to modernization, and strive together for more fruitful outcomes under the Global Civilization Initiative. We should jointly advance modernization that is eco-friendly. Green development is a hallmark of modernization in the new era. China is ready to help Africa build green growth engines, narrow the gap in energy accessibility, adhere to the principle of common but differentiated responsibilities and jointly push for the global transition to green and low carbon development. We should jointly advance modernization underpinned by peace and security. Modernization would not be possible without a peaceful and stable environment for development. China is ready to help Africa improve its capacity in safeguarding peace and stability independently, prioritize Africa in implementing the Global Security Initiative, promote mutual reinforcement of high-quality development and greater security, and work together with Africa to uphold world peace and stability.
Friends and distinguished guests, China and Africa account for one-third of the world population. Without our modernization, there will be no global modernization. In the next 3 years, China will work with Africa to take the following 10 partnership actions for modernization to deepen China-Africa cooperation and spearhead the Global South modernization. First, the partnership action for a mutual learning among civilizations. China is ready to work with Africa to build a platform for governance experience sharing, China-African knowledge network for development, and 25 centers on China and Africa studies. We will make better use of Africa's leadership academies to cultivate talents for governance and invite 1,000 members of African political parties to China to deepen exchanges of experiences in party and state governance. Second, the partnership action for trade prosperity. China will voluntarily and unilaterally open its market wider. We have decided to give all LDCs having diplomatic relations with China, including 33 countries in Africa, zero tariff treatment for 100% tariff lines. This has made China the first major developing country and the first major economy to take such a step. It will help turn China's big market into Africa's big opportunity. China will expand market access for African agricultural products, deepen cooperation with Africa in e-commerce and other areas, and also launch a China-Africa quality enhancement program. We are prepared to enter into a framework agreement on economic partnership for shared development with African countries to provide long-term, stable, and predictable institutional guarantee for trade and investment between the two sides. Third, the partnership action for industry chain cooperation. China will foster industry cooperation growth clusters with Africa, push forward the pilot zone for in-depth China-Africa economic and trade cooperation and launch an African SMEs empowerment program. We will build with Africa a digital technology cooperation center and initiate 20 digital demonstration projects so as to embrace together the latest round of technological revolution and industry transformation. Fourth, the partnership action for connectivity. China is prepared to carry out 30 infrastructure connectivity projects in Africa, promote together high-quality Belt and Road Cooperation, and put in place a China-Africa network featuring land-sea links and coordinated development. We are ready to assist in the development of the African continental free trade area and deepen logistics and financial cooperation for the benefit of transregional development in Africa. Fifth, the partnership action for development cooperation. China is ready to release the joint statement on deepening cooperation within the framework of the Global Development Initiative with Africa and implement 1,000 small and beautiful livelihood projects. We will replenish the China World Bank Group partnership facilities to boost Africa's development. We support Africa in hosting the 2026 Youth Olympic Games and the 2027 Africa Cup of Nations. We will work together with Africa to deliver more fruits of development to the two peoples. Sixth, the partnership action for health. China is ready to establish with Africa a hospitals alliance and joint medical centers. We will send 2,000 medical personnel to Africa and launch 20 programs of health facilities and malaria treatment. We will encourage Chinese companies to invest in Africa's pharmaceutical production and continue to do what we can to help Africa with epidemic response. We support the development of the Africa Centers for Disease Control and Prevention to strengthen public health capacity in all African countries. Seventh, the partnership action for agriculture and livelihoods. China will provide Africa with 1 billion RMB in emergency food assistance, build 100,000 of standardized agriculture demonstration areas in Africa, send 500 agriculture experts, and establish a China-Africa Agriculture Science and Technological Innovation Alliance. We will implement 500 programs in Africa to promote community welfare. We will also encourage the two-way investment for new business operations by Chinese African companies, enable Africa to retain added value, and also create at least 1 million jobs for Africa. Eighth, the partnership action for people-to-people exchanges. China will implement with Africa more solid the future of Africa vocational education cooperation plan, establish together an engineering technology academy, and build 10 Luban workshops. We will also provide 60,000 training opportunities to Africa, mainly for women and youth. We will launch with Africa a Cultural Silk Road program, as well as an initiative of cooperation on innovation in radio, TV, and audio and visual programs. The two sides have agreed to designate 2026 as the China-Africa Year of People-to-People Exchanges. Ninth, the partnership action for green development. China is ready to launch 30 clean energy projects in Africa, putting in place meteorological early warning systems and carry out cooperation in disaster prevention, mitigation, and relief, as well as the biodiversity conservation. We will create a China-Africa Forum on peaceful use of nuclear technology, establish together 30 joint laboratories, and collaborate on satellite remote sensing and lunar and deep space exploration. All this is destined to help the green development in Africa.
Tenth, the partnership action for common security. China is ready to build with Africa a partnership for implementing the Global Security Initiative, or GSI, and make it a fine example of GSI cooperation. We will give Africa 1 billion RMB of grants in military assistance, provide training for 6,000 military personnel and 1,000 police and law enforcement officers from Africa, and invite 500 young African military officers to visit China. The two sides will conduct joint military exercises, training, and patrol, carry out an action for a mine-free Africa, and jointly ensure the safety of personnel and projects. To implement the 10 partnership actions, the Chinese government will provide 360 billion RMB of financial support through the next 3 years. This breaks down into 210 billion RMB of credit line, 80 billion RMB of assistance in various forms, and at least 70 billion RMB of investment in Africa by Chinese companies. In addition, China will encourage and support Africa in issuing panda bonds in China to enhance our results-oriented cooperation in all areas. Friends and distinguished guests, the Communist Party of China held in July the successful third plenary session of its 20th Central Committee. laying out systematic plans for further deepening reform comprehensively to advance Chinese modernization. This will profoundly further transform China. It will also provide new opportunities and new driving forces for African countries and for our joint pursuit of modernization. As an African proverb goes, a friend is someone you share the path with. On the path to modernization, no one and no country should be left behind. Let us rally the more than 2.8 billion Chinese and African people into a powerful force on our shared path toward modernization. Promote modernization of the Global South with China-Africa modernization and write a new magnificent chapter of development in human history. Let us join hands to bring about a bright future of peace, security, prosperity, and progress for our world. Thank you.